Greetings. Thank you so much for joining me. This is Jenny Oya with Nuggets and Things. Oh my gracious, I've had a fabulous day already, and it's probably not even 10 o'clock. I went out this morning for my casual walk, and while I was out there walking, I've got it on video, so I'm going to submit it. But I wanted you to hear me first, because somehow or another, I got so excited that I never completed. I thought I was still talking and completing my video, but apparently I didn't. So it seems incomplete, but you will get the gist of it. You will get the gist of it. You know, there is a saying that when the student is ready, the master will come, right? That when the student is ready to be taught what is meant for them to know, someone will come. The teacher will come and teach them. Because it's time. Everything's about timing. When is the right time for you to be able to receive the information you need to receive? So today, I want to share a little bit with those of you who may be seeking answers. Just seeking answers. All I choose to do, everything I do, is all about just making you think. You know, you always see me pointing, just making you think. And I always point to the right side, because the right side of the brain needs to always be activated. Most of us work that left. We need to work that right side of the brain. You know, get to a place where you can activate that right side more than you do your left. Because this is the side that will awaken you. This is the side that will cause you to think outside of everything else. You'll see differently. You'll view things differently, right? Now everybody can look at one picture and they say, what do you see? So I said, I see this, I see that, whatever. But you'll be able to see things differently because you're activating your right side of your brain. And all I choose to do is help you think. That's all. You know, it's no right or wrong. It's wherever you are. That's your perception. Wherever you are, right? You're not expected to understand things. We wasn't expected to understand things as our parents did when we were still children. They had a reason why they did what they did at the timing and what they did it, in which they did it. We didn't understand it. We may not even agree with it, but they made the decision at an adult level, right? And somehow it always panned out correctly. So sometimes you don't understand what people do, why they do it, when they do it, but somewhere down the line you'll see, you know, now I know why they did it that way. I cannot tell you the many times I disagreed with someone who was teaching me. I didn't agree with what they were saying because I wasn't at the level that I could understand it. And until you get to the level in which your teacher is at, you can't understand how they're teaching because they're the teacher. You're the student, right? We get that confused so many times. We think, you know, we think that we are everything. You know, learn to be a great student. Every great student will be awesome teachers, because you know how to sit still and listen, take in the information needed, and take that information to help somebody else. That's all you do. It's constantly moving, like the ocean, like the sea, right? It never stops. The water always flowing. Information is like water. It should continue to flow. When you get information, it should continue to flow. When you receive information, continue to flow. When you give information, continue to flow. Because once you give it and it's, you know, now has processed this way, then more information should be coming in. We should be always to a place that information is constantly moving in our life, always, right? And so when we look at life and look at our own life, we understand the levels in which we are on. No two people are very seldom on the same level. There are people who understand things at a deeper depth. I sit back and listen to people sometimes. I'm like, man, good gracious, where their brain at, right? Because they like, that right side is turned on. And they be teaching and I'm like, it's way above me. I was listening, I think, to Mr. Howard. And he was saying how 1 + 1 = 2. No, 1 × 1 = 2. 1 × 1 = 2. And so I'm trying to figure out how you do that. He said, get your calculator. And they went back and forth. And then I realized what, you know, what seems simple to us and what we don't understand. And when you don't understand something, we attack it because we don't understand it. We attack anything we don't understand, right? It doesn't mean it doesn't exist. You just attack it because it's at the level that which you are at, it doesn't exist where you are. It doesn't mean it doesn't exist, period, in this universe. You're just not on the level that you can understand it nor receive it. So what you do is you will what? You'll refute it, and you will definitely take the time to make sure that you don't pull it in. Right? You'll criticize what you don't understand because it's not at the level in which you understand it. It doesn't make it less true because you're not on the level. It just means you're not. It's not your timing yet for you to know that. That's not the information that you need to know at this particular time. And that's okay too. You know, we're all on different places in our life, right? Like some people say that, you know, they understand things in 3D. Some people are on 5D, right? And some people don't understand that. They're thinking about, you know, you know, the different, what you call it, waves. And it's your mindset, what you're able to receive, right? You talking about the 3G and they talking about the 5G. I'm talking about 3D. I know my letters now. And I'm talking about the 5D, the fifth dimension, third dimension, you know, where you are and how you view and see things at wherever dimension you're at. Understanding that, you know, it doesn't make anybody no better or no less. It just says where you are is where you receive at. You know, that's where your reception comes in. That's how you're able to pick up. Based on the level and where you are. And you cannot get upset with someone else because they're at a different level than you. Whether it's higher or lower, that's where they are. Leave them alone. Let them process at their time frame. And in, you know, in the level in which they can. Right? So as I am teaching maybe at different levels which people can understand, but it's okay. When one of my teachers, you know, back home, when he was teaching me, I didn't understand what he was saying. So, you know, sometimes I rejected it. I rejected it because I didn't understand it, because he was on a different level than me. He had more experience than me. He saw things I'd never seen before. He'd been places I'd never been before. So he could talk about things I would never know. And instead of me, you know, grasping it and receiving it, and like, you know, sometimes people say, you know, take it, put it in a bucket, and you may not need it today. But at some point in your life, you'll find now the information you got is now worthy for you to go in that bucket and say, now I can get some information and I can receive it. Don't discard everything that you don't understand. Because you don't understand, don't make it less true. It's just you haven't got to that place to understand it. Somebody who is talking to you at a level, let's say they try to talk to you. You know, I have people all the time with this large vocabulary, right? And they have a large vocabulary. And when they're talking to me with this large vocabulary, I'm like, hey, if you want to get a point across to me, you need to break it down. You know, I don't want to have my dictionary open every time you talk to me. I understand you're intelligent. I know you're intellectual. I know you got a large vocabulary, but it does you no good to have that if nobody understands you. You know, you're talking, you know, almost in a Greek language to people, you know, who are, you know, who speaks, you know, French, right? So, you know, we're in two different paths, but break it down so people can receive you. And then what you're saying is more productive. And you want whatever you say, especially if you're teaching. When you're teaching, you want the information that you're giving to be productive. You want it to be received, accepted, so they can digest it, right? And process it to use it wherever they need to go in their life. So in our lives, wherever we are, whatever we're doing, understand that you just go, you flow. Flow where you are. And those that can, will. Those that can't, will try. And those that don't want to, you'll never catch them anyway. You know? When you take, it's like fishing, right? When you take your reel and you throw it out there, right? Some say you threw it out too far. You know, if you plan on catching this kind of fish, you threw it out too far. Some say you didn't throw it out far enough because the big ones are way out there. But you threw it where you need to throw it. And whatever is meant to catch what you got will catch it. And what isn't, they won't. Today. But there may be a day they will. They say, you know what? I remember this lady was talking about this. Let me go back in my little, you know, archives and pick up what they said, because now it's making sense. Because information, when it goes out, it, you know, it doesn't disintegrate. The information is still there. If someone has spoken something into your life, you have still got it. It's here. You just got to what? Activate it. Bring it back. You know, as a scripture says, you know, bring it back to your remembrance. Pull that information back to you. Bring it back so you can understand what was given to you maybe 8 years ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago. You didn't understand it then. But now, you know, you're awakened to it. You awoke, they say, I'm woke now. Now you woke to it. Now you can say, yeah, now I understand how it makes sense. Don't reject everything because you don't understand it today. You know, there's a lot of stuff that I don't know. I don't understand. But given time, if it's meant for me to know, it will come. And I will receive it. And so will you. So I must begin, you know, to do what I'm given in hopes that those that I have been given it to have, you know, will receive it, and they will, and hold tight to it, and they shall, and use it with whatever they need it for, and I know it will happen. You got to be you. Choose never to be somebody else. Choose never to be somebody else. You'll never be fully effective trying to be somebody else, ever. Be you, and I guarantee you, you'll never be disappointed in those who come to you, because you're just you. Just you, honey. You know? There's some people who look at you and just think you just, oh my God, you're priceless. There's other people look at you and say, you know, I ain't studied nothing that he or she is saying. Right? But that's where they are. And that's the level in which they stand. And you can't change people for levels that in which they are. That's where they are. That's it. Don't allow somebody else's thoughts of you, ideals of you, you know, what they heard, think, or feel like they know, cause you to change who you are. Be you and send the message out. Say what you got to say. Do what you're supposed to do, and trust that you have been appointed at that time to do what you do. Right? And then walk in it. Oh my gracious, walk in it, honey. When you're proud of something, you walk that thing. You walk it. Because you're proud of who you are. Sometimes you got to, you know, they say, hold your chin up. Come, hold your chin up. You know? Don't be looking down for what? Everything you need is above you. You know? Look up. And you'll see exactly where you're supposed to be. Who you're supposed to be with. Why you're supposed to be there. It's you know, it's already designated for you. Destined for you. Empowered to you. Trusted to you. You know? And it's good that someone trusts you with valuable information and valuable people. Ain't that something? When somebody can trust you with you. You know? That's a good thing. You know? Everybody can't be trusted with you. But you got some that can. Because of who you are. When the student is ready, the master will come. Only when they're ready. And you can talk like you're ready and not be ready. But when you're ready, you'll grab a seat, snatch a pen, get your paper, and you'll start to write. Because now you're going to take notes. Because this information is what you need to get you to another level, to get you to another place, to a better understanding. So you're going to what? A student pays attention. And sometimes they're very silent because you miss stuff while you're talking, while the teacher's talking. Don't you miss things? Then you got to look at somebody and say, what they say? What they say? And how come you don't know what they said? Because you was distracted or you were trying to talk. And you know, there's many times I would conduct meetings and there'd be somebody talking while I'm trying to conduct a meeting. And I would say, oh, I say, did you hear what I just said? Oh no, I said, of course not, because you were talking. I said, now when I get finished, I'm gonna give you all the time you need to ask questions, to do whatever you need to say, that'd be your time. Right now, there's other people in the room who want this information. And you are distracting them by talking, right? And you don't have answers for them. So allow the teacher to teach. And remain a student just a little while longer. And then I'll let you teach. Is that all right? You know? Is it okay? You know? Because sometimes it's confusing when you got two teachers in a room. It's confusing. You know? You see that sometimes it kind of aggravates people. And they'll tell me about it. They says, I was trying to listen to what you got to say, but that person was talking and they were doing this. And you knew they were out of order. And you wonder why they don't know it. You're out of order. Stop talking. Stop distracting. Because if you don't want the information, then you shouldn't be in the class. Right? You shouldn't be in the class if you don't want the information. Let somebody have the seat that you're occupying that you don't really want. Isn't it amazing? Right? People want that seat because people want that information because it's valuable. And you occupying a seat and you don't want the information, you just occupying a seat. You know, that's unnecessary. If you don't agree with the person who is teaching, don't be in the class. That's what I tell people all the time. Everybody ain't meant for you and you ain't meant for everybody. But those who are meant for you, they'll walk with you. They'll back you. They'll support you. They'll be there for you. Right? But those that ain't, they'll buck you every step of the way. I used to say this in our ministry all the time. I said there's three kinds of people that normally shows up to church. Three kinds of people who normally shows up to church. You got the sheep, you got the goats, and you got the wolves. And I ask, which one are you? Are you the sheep that wants to be taught? Are you the goat that's going to butt everything that's happened? Or are you the wolf that's here to attack the pastor? You know? And I said, and when you walk into a door, I radar you. I know exactly who you are. Because your character can't be hidden. You resemble exactly who you are. Every time somebody's talking, you got something to say. Ooh, there goes the goat. When someone is talking, you sit passionate, waiting, and receive it. Oh, a beautiful sheep. When somebody is moving, you're looking, trying to see how can you manipulate them, confuse them, distract them, and then take them out. That's a wolf, right? You know, some people's eyes is never closed. Even when they sleep, they're not asleep. They don't see what's happening. Pay attention to that, right? Oh, no greater thing, no greater will is to have the wisdom to have your eyes open. And when you have your eyes open and you have been awakened, refuse to ever go back to sleep. Thank you so much for your time. I pray that you have been enlightened, that you got the information that was meant for you. You have received it and you're able to move with that. Let your light forever shine. Be awesome. Be great. Don't stop being you. And never stop being a student. Because you are also a great teacher. Everybody's a teacher. And so are you. And it's a time that you sit. And it's a time that you stand. Know that place. And do that. I love you. You have a fabulous day today. Because I will. Be blessed.